She was larger than life. Rose LaRose, Queen of Burlesque, and she made her home in Toledo.
She came to Toledo in 1958.
Historian Ken Dixon authored a recent book called Teasingly Yours on Rose's colorful life.
And there were two theaters available. One was in Cincinnati and the other one was in Toledo. And before she could make an offer, the one in Cincinnati sold and she purchased the Town Hall Theater.
It was an historic theater at Orange and St. Clair, had many incarnations, but in the 50s, home to many luring ladies who dared to dance wearing little more than a smile and a few inches of fabric. Its marquee became a destination and a rite of passage for generations of young men looking to shed their innocence. By the time Rose had arrived in Toledo, she had already enjoyed much fame and fortune on the infamous bump and grind circuit.
She started at Minsky's Theater on 42nd Street as a cashier. Minsky moved her up to a bookkeeper. And at that point, she found out how much the burlesque queens were making. And she says, I can do that.
And did she ever? Not just as a popular stripper, but the Queen of Burlesque, making thousands of dollars a week during the Depression, even working sometimes as a spokesperson for commercials for products like Pepsi. Her good looks and her personality won hearts and sometimes blood.
Rose had the largest blood drives for World War II. And she was given a commendation, and I think she collected more blood than any other performer.
Upon moving to Toledo, her charity continued, as she raised money for many causes here, including the Old Newsboys charity drive.
The Old Newsboys were one of her pet projects, and she gave them a lot of money. I mean a lot of money.
But by the late 1960s, the naughty charm of live vaudeville-type burlesque was starting to fade. And so, too, was the city's tolerance of it. An urban renewal project put the old Town Hall Theater in the path of a wrecking ball. She fought it, and she lost. Sort of. For she was able to move her shows to the Esquire Theater on Superior Street. But
times were changing. And Rose knew that times were changing.
It seemed the audience was more interested in adult movies instead of live burlesque. She didn't like it.
And she said it was time to go.
A few years later, Rose LaRose contracted inoperable cancer. And in late July of 1972, 48 years ago, she exited the theater of her life, leaving behind a long legacy of memories here and a lot of impressions.
The more that I got into her biography, the more I found out that she was just a fantastic woman who would do anything for anybody and was absolutely brilliant at what she did.
Blade reporter Seymour Rothman said, "Don't pity Rose in her death. Pity those who never got to know her." Thank you.